My friends in tech tell me a lot, James, I don't know my place in the church. Like, man, we gotta figure that out. I remember I was out for coffee with a friend once. He comes over, sits down. I was like, hey, he worked in tech. And I was like, what do you do for church? How are you involved in your church? This guy's like, I run PowerPoint. I was like, classic, right? Put the tech guy on PowerPoint, love it. I was like, what's your background? Like, what'd you do in work? He goes, well, I helped invent BlackBerry Messenger, one of the first text messaging platforms in the world. It's like, oh, okay. I should have done my research before I met with you, you know? And I was like, why are you doing PowerPoint? I was like, look, we need PowerPoint. People are called to do PowerPoint. But I was like, this guy. And I remember saying to him, could you build some sort of global platform? I didn't know really what I was talking about fully, you know, a global platform to help all the missionaries around the world share resources. That seems like a big thing you can do. I remember this guy, we're sitting down, he stops and he looks up for like a minute and a half. And I'm like, it's super awkward. And then I start looking up, like, what's this guy looking at? And I'm like, is it a vent issue? Like, what's going on up there? You know what's going on, right? He's building the platform because the numbers are, I'm like, I don't see them. Where are the numbers? I don't see them, you know? And I'll never forget, he looks down on me after a minute and a half and he goes, yeah, I could build that. Yes. And I remember saying to him though, I said, why don't you? And this was the turning point in my thinking. He goes, no one ever told me that's a way I could steward my skills to glorify God and serve the church. You know, the Bible says we are created in Christ Jesus. We are his craftsmanship, his workmanship to do good works that he prepared in advance for us to do. Some of you are called to do the PowerPoint and serve the church diligently that way, and amen to that. And some of us are also called to look at the talents and the skills God has given us and to say, how could I innovate? How could I create to glorify God in a unique creative way, because man, God has created me to create and be creative. So this is what I encourage you to reflect on. Look to see where God has called you based on the skills, the unique skills God has given you, and may we use those to his glory.